Hello everyone, this is Couple. Welcome back to A Couple Books. A few things, first of all. Number one, we are ending the book giveaway thing today. So if you've not yet put in your name, it's probably already too late by this video. So just so you guys know, but there's always a chance to just throw in your name if you can real quick. I made the video about a week ago under special announcements and book reviews. And I am giving away a book to someone who wins the raffle in order to basically get super excited about the fact that we passed 50 subscribers, which is super exciting for everyone, including me and you and everyone. So that out of the way, we'll be doing the raffle later on. I'll be making that video very shortly, probably tomorrow. So super excited about doing that and getting someone a book. That is very exciting for me. It's going to be very exciting for whoever wins. And if you're empathetic, it will probably be exciting for you as well. So overall, with all that excitement out of the way, let's get into what this video is about today. Today we are discussing basically my October-November wrap-up. So it is now December 1st or 2nd. The days just kind of merged together at this point. Like, what day is it even? Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday? I don't know. Maybe you know. I don't. But that's not the point. We are here because I have done 2 TBR listing videos so far since the birth of this channel, and that would be my October Not Spooky Edition TBR and my Thanksgiving Break TBR. We're just going to quickly go through those books and see what I did and didn't complete and then go from there, because I'm also a mood reader, which I know this about myself, but I have to remind myself sometimes in the mirror that I'm a mood reader. And even though I have a TBR pile this tall, I will sometimes go over and choose these random books that have nothing to do with my TBR pile. So let's get started. So first of all, in terms of my October TBR, I was planning on reading Peace Talks by Jim Butcher, The Silent Patient by Alex. you'll find his name down below, his last name. I just won't butcher it again. The Troop by Nick Cutter and Sleeping Giants by Sylvain Nouvel. I was very successful in terms of the fact that I completed 3 of those 4 books, which is super exciting. And then for the Thanksgiving TBR, which was less successful, we had Amassed Masked. Where's the K? I forget how to say the word. M-A-S-K-E-D. Masked City by Genevieve Cogman, which is the second book in the Invisible Library series. We had The Queen of Sorrow, which is the third book in the Queen of Renthia series by Sarah Beth Durst. And we had The Whisper Man by Alex North. We had a lot of books on the TBR piles, and I was somewhat successful this time. I only read one of them, The Whisper Man by Alex North. But don't you guys fret, I read a lot of other books, so it's A-okay. So, Nova, my dog, has decided to join us for the remainder of this video. Continuing on, let's just go through these real quick. So, everyone knows Peace Talks, that is the continuation of The Dresden Files by Jim Butcher. It is, I don't even know which number, somewhere above 15. Apologies, I'll put the number right, boom, right there. It was fantastic. I can't really talk about it since, first of all, I don't have the time to talk about it without trying to move around spoilers. And it was good. I enjoyed it a lot. I am giving it 5 out of 5 stars. This is absolutely fantastic, and it did a lot of callbacks to previous books and the side stories and the short story collections. It was absolutely fantastic. I loved every second of it. The Troop by Nick Cutter. This was a horror thriller. I gave it 5 out of 5 stars. It basically follows 5 boys who are part of a Boy Scout troop, and them and their scout leader or team leader, whatever they're called, go out to this island. And basically horribleness happens. There's a virus involved, and it's disgusting. It was really graphic and horrible in so many ways, but also an super ecstatic journey along the way. And I was revolted, and I was vegetarian for a solid week afterwards. I give that 5 out of 5. It was absolutely fantastic. Loved it so much. Sleeping Giants by Sylvain Nouvel. This is a sci-fi series, and it basically follows this doctor who, as a little kid, she fell into this pit, and in this pit there were like limbs of a giant human. There was these limbs. And now later on, it follows this team as they do this insane research project, as they attempt to basically figure out what these limbs belong to, and it, we follow them throughout their journey as they discover more parts of this seemingly massive, giant-sized robot that is based off of a humanoid structure, or it's a humanoid structure robot. I don't know how to say it, but you guys get what I'm saying. It's a gigantic robot. It's a human, but it's a robot. It was super fantastic. I listened to the audio version, and they did different voice actors for the different characters, and it was such a fun ride. It was really enjoyable. If you're into sci-fi, absolutely fantastic. I'm giving it 4 out of 5 stars. There were some plot points I didn't really enjoy and some characters I didn't really enjoy. Not in the sense that they were really well-written bad characters, but in the sense that they were just poorly written, could have been great characters, and I just didn't really enjoy it. But overall, the storyline was absolutely fantastic. I was interested in the story from the get-go. Character work could have been more. 4 out of 5 stars. Absolutely love Sylvie Neuvel. Super excited to get into her next books, even though that sounded super critical of me just now. I hate giving bad ratings to books. I'm not sure if you guys have noticed that, but it's a fact. Okay, continuing on. Now into my Thanksgiving TBR. As I said, I had those 3 books. I only did one, the Alex North book, The Whisper Man, which basically is about this small town called Featherbank, where there was once a serial killer called The Whisper Man who used to whisper outside kids' windows at night before kidnapping them and taking them away. And he was captured by a detective named Pete. And now 20 years later, we are following two storylines. We have Tom and Jake, who are father and son, who have just moved to Featherbank. And we have Pete, the original police officer who arrested the original Whisper Man, Amanda, who is the new detective on the case, the lead detective. And basically the stories converge as there is a Whisper Man copycat out there. And it was super exciting, kind of scary, really good thriller, absolutely fantastic, 5 out of 5 stars, loved it so much. Most of these books, except for Sleeping Giants and the Dresden book, I have in-depth book reviews, which I will comment down below as well. So moving out of my TBRs, let's move into the books I actually did finish. So as well, in the month of October and November, I read The Last Smile in Sunderland City by Luke Arnold. This was an absolute fantastic book. It basically is in an alternate world similar to ours where humans still exist, but they have lived aside magical creatures pretty much since the get-go. They've worked together. There's been, of course, issues and tensions between the races, which led, unfortunately, to the current climate that we find ourselves in the book, where humans have basically taken magic away, and all the once magical creatures, majestic creatures out there that lived alongside the humans, their magic has disappeared. So a lot of creatures either died or are dying since they no longer have their magic to sustain them. The world itself, which ran on a combination of magic and technology, has kind of crumbled apart, and we are following Fetch Phillips, who is a private detective who is a human, but he only works for magical people solving their cases. And so we follow him as he's investigating the disappearance of a vampire who is just so happens to be a school teacher. So it was a really fun ride. The world is fantastic. I don't remember what rating I gave it, but I'm going to go back, if I am going back, or I'm going to stay on my previous rating of 4 out of 5 stars. Absolutely fantastic. Really excited to get in. It was a debut novel. The writing was excellent. I had a few issues with a few things, but nothing too extreme. Overall, it was a great book. I'm really looking forward to picking up the second one. The next book I read was A Deadly Education by Naomi Novik. I gave this 4.5 out of 5 stars. This is taking place in a magical school. We have these teenagers who, in the outside world, are most likely, due to their magical essence aura, are going to be eaten by monsters or killed by monsters out there in the real world. So their parents all collectively decided generations ago to basically put all these teenagers in a school where they could like self-teach themselves magic and basically be protected from these monsters and eventually graduate, move on into the real world where they would have enough magic and be older so they wouldn't be such an easy victim to these horrendous creatures that lived amongst them in the world. It was a super exciting book. I really loved it. I thought it was really interesting. I am going to change my rating note after this time because I really have had an issue with the info dumping that was in this book just because it was a new world and it was super interesting. But as you guys will know in my more in-depth review, which will be down below as well, It was not really my cup of tea in terms of the info dumping, which is why I give it 4.5, but the info dumping was a big issue, and I thought that there could have been a more succinct way of telling the background of this world. Overall, I wanted to give it 4 out of 5 stars. It was a fantastic start to a series. Really looking forward to the second one by Naomi Novik. The next book I read was 12 Nights at Rotterdam House. And the book is called Rotterdam Mansion by J.W. Ocker. I gave this as well 4.5 out of 5 stars. This is a horror book that basically follows this adventure journalist who writes these books on like haunted places or places with a lot of like folk tales. And he goes to these places and writes a book. He decides this time he needs to write Amityville horror book. So he goes to this place called Rotterdam Mansion and he plans to stay there 13 nights. Since the book is called 12 Nights, we know it doesn't work out so well. I went in, I really loved this book. And it was really interesting, and the whole storyline was very interesting. The ending was out of this world. I did not expect it, did not see it coming. Though, in retrospect, I should have seen it coming since it's been done before. It wasn't anything super original, but for me, it was original since it was really the first time I've seen it done. Overall, I gave it 4.5 out of 5 stars. I'm going to stick with that. I thought it was fantastic. I really enjoyed it. And while it's not necessarily a completely new idea what happens throughout the book, it was interesting to me. So yeah, that's 12 Nights at Rotterdam House. The next book I read was Kings of the Wild by Nicholas Eames. I gave this as well 4.5 out of 5 stars because I apparently really love 4.5. This was the start in his Nicholas Eames series, basically in a fantasy world where these groups of adventurers, the bands, they go out and they fight monsters and they collect fame and fortune off of this, and they basically become rock stars in their world. And it was all kind of based on this metaphor of a rock band with the drummer and the singer and all these people. They kind of form up to join a band and they go on tours. Except in this world, these bands don't sing or perform. They go on tours to go kill monsters. It also reminded me of D&D Adventures. Overall, it was a really fun ride. I really enjoyed it as well. It was super fantastic. I stick by my rating on this one. It was really fun and I'm really looking forward to the next one, and it was a blast. Also, for those who would like D&D and adventure stuff and fantasy worlds, it really just does it super well. I highly recommend it. The next one I read was Meddling Kids by Edgar Quintero. I gave this book 4 out of 5 stars. This basically follows a Scooby-Doo revival where it's this gang and they used to solve mysteries together when they were teenagers, and now they've all kind of grown up and they've all ended up in different places throughout their lives. One's in an insane asylum, one's dead, one is a failed biologist and is a bartender currently, the other one's on the run from the law. So and there's of course a dog involved, because there has to be a dog involved, otherwise it's not such a good story. We follow these characters as they go out and basically reunite to go solve one of their last crimes that they solved back when they were teenagers at the small town. So they all get together, except for obviously the dead one, and they go back down to the small town to resolve their last crime. I really enjoyed it. There were a lot of culture references. There was horror references to like Lovecraft, and it was a really fun adventure book. And while it definitely is classified as horror, I would definitely define it as much more like a horror adjacent adventure book. It was really fun, really unique monsters. It was a joyful ride. My issue was with his writing, which I stand by that with being a 4 out of 5 stars. I really was just not a huge fan of some of the writing things he did, and some of his continuity was off for me personally. So that is the reason for that rating, but I still highly recommend it. The other book I read was The Invisible Library by Genevieve Cogman, which was a fantastic read. 4 out of 5 stars. It was the introduction to this new world with fae and dragons and this massive library that lives between all these parallel worlds. And these librarians who were following one of the librarians named Irene as she goes in between these worlds to collect books of fiction from each of these worlds. More specifically, in this book, she goes to one particular world to collect one particular book, and along the way she kind of gets involved in this heinous crime world that involved fae and all this stuff. It was absolutely a really fun steampunky Victorian era fantasy adventure. I enjoyed it. It had some of my favorite things in it. My issue was is that I felt like some of their tropes were more obvious, and these were the tropes that I felt like were a little overdone. And henceforth, I'm giving it a 4 out of 5 stars, but I thought the world was very unique, and I'm looking forward to eventually finishing A Mass City by her, which is the second book in that series. Then, as well, some books that I haven't really done reviews for on this channel yet is Ascend Online by Luke Chmielenko, which is the first book in the Ascend Online series, which is a lit RPG novel. This book and series in whole follows a group of friends, and the main character, his name is Marcus, and he is an avid gamer, and they kind of live in this futuristic society, I believe it's the year 2047, where they haven't really had a chance to get real jobs because people are able to get older, and a lot of the jobs that we would typically see in our world have disappeared due to advances in technology. So a lot of these people, the only thing they have time to do, or the only thing they're able to do with their time, is either sit on the couch or play video games. So there's now this super virtual reality MMORPG, this super, super realistic video game where a player like can feel everything with all five senses, and they actually like are pretty much in every sense of the word, but actually there in the world that they're playing the game in. And so we follow Marcus and his friends as they travel into this fantasy world with all these monsters there and all these like political struggles going on, and you know, this insane back history going on. It's basically just like a super fun adventure story set in a fantasy world, except for the fact that it's all a game. And so all these there's these quests, and that there's these items to collect, and there's like mission logs, there's dialogue in like chat windows. It was like super fun to read. I really enjoyed it. It was a super fun genre to get into. I'm going to give that book, honestly, 5 out of 5 stars. I really thought it was a hot start. And then I loved it so much, I picked up the second book in the series called Hell to Pay by Luke Chmielenko. And this is the second book in the Ascend Online series, except that this one kind of goes offshoot. The storyline is adjacent or parallel to the story that's introduced in the first book, where we're following this guy named Lazarus, who is also a player in this video game, except he didn't decide to go out into the wild and hunt monsters and earn his fortune that way. Instead, he decided to stay in the city and become part of one of the crime families or syndicates in the city itself, where he's basically a criminal and operating out of sight of the city watch and operating outside of the law, but inside his own little like thief world with its own rules and stuff. I really enjoyed it. I thought that it was interesting because there was this whole tightly woven mystery going on at the same time. And I thought that introducing all these characters, which come up in book 3 of this series, as we return to the main storyline, was a really interesting way of introducing these characters and giving them a nice backstory. And I thought that the mystery was really well done as well. I really enjoyed it immensely. I'm giving it 4 out of 5 stars for this book because I did think that there were a few issues, which I can go in depth another time on. But overall, the storyline was interesting. The characters were very fun to read about. Some of the characters were kind of in the background outside of like the main three that we were pretty much with the entire time. Motivations kind of got murky for me with other characters, hence why I'm giving it the 4 out of 5 stars. But overall, it was a fantastic journey in terms of like exploring the city world of this genre versus exploring the more outside, adventure-y, small town version of this world as we did in the first book. Lastly, but not least, I read The Reluctant Queen by Sarah Beth Durst, which is the second book in the Queens of Renthia series, which I'm planning on reading the third book very soon, as it was on my last TBR. This book follows, it takes place in this world, the Queens of Renthia world, where basically all of nature has these life forms attached to it, these like creatures who are basically like spirits. So like there's like wood spirits, wind spirits, water spirits, you get the drift. And these spirits really hate humans, but in this world, women, not all, but some women have the power to control these spirits. And we basically are following characters. In the first book, we followed a woman as she was preparing to become a heir to the throne, meaning that she is a woman who has been trained in the powers to eventually take over the queen's position when or if she dies or falls or whatever. In order to ensure that the human survival takes place, so that, because if there's no queen, then there's no one controlling these spirits, and then they'll just go out and kill all the humans, since the only thing keeping in check is the queen. I really enjoyed the first book in the series. The reason I'm going to be giving this book 3 out of 5 stars is because I thought that I didn't really see anything new done compared to the first book. We just had some new character introductions and further character development. And while I really did enjoy some of that, I kind of wish that it was a little different. I kind of felt like I was just rereading the same book, except with like a new face as our main character, and having our old previous character be just a secondary primary character, but not our main character. So overall, I really enjoyed it, thought it was a great read. I just didn't think it was that much different, hence why I'm giving it 3 out of 5 stars. That's what I've read so far in, or not so far, that's what I read in October and November. And it being December, can't read any more than those months. So that is my wrap up for you guys. I know it was a lot of books. Apologies if I didn't go into depth in any of them. Any of my more in-depth book reviews, I'll be dropping down below. So don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll be seeing you guys tomorrow. So, toodaloo, this has been Koppel. This has been Koppel Books, and thank you for your time.